We got a lot of recognition from other states and just people on social media, like, amazed of that we did that as a team.
I truly believe that we are in contention for the greatest Nebraska high school cross country team to ever come through the state.
Just something that's never been done before, or something unexpected for most people.
Millard West, home to some of the best high school sports in Nebraska. The Wildcats have over 30 state championships and a handful of national championships.
I mean, like, it's just really nothing like any other school could really generate. It's just been like, it's a welcoming family, like from the freshmen that are just now getting like to the school to like the seniors that are just now like getting into it later in the years, and which is fine for both. But yeah, it's just like a welcoming environment that like I don't think any other school could really reproduce. And I'm just so glad that I started joining the activities, because it just creates that energy in the environment that like is will last forever and like I always kind of remember.
In the midst of all the activities at West, cross country did the unbelievable this year. But before we get to the finish, we have to start at the origin. Cross country is known for being one of the hardest and most painful sports. However, Millard West makes it look easy. 2020 was an odd year for everyone, and it especially affected the cross country scene since they run in large races. The boys team came up just shy of winning state in 2020. They lost to the Fremont Tigers. At the beginning of the 2021 season, Millard West looked unstoppable, win after win after win.
Classic champion for the varsity boys. They scored 65 points today. Millard West.
It was going really well. We were a very powerful team. We were pretty much undefeated up until Rimrock, and we went undefeated after that. And we were very confident in ourselves. We were well established, and we were just racing very well and really smart.
Rimrock, one of the few out-of-state meets on the University of Kansas's home course. The competition was very high, and the Wildcats still finished in second place without one of their top runners. The Wildcats would lose to Valor Christian, a nationally ranked team.
Rimrock in Lawrence, Kansas was a good meet, and because it gave us some national competition with Valor Christian, and unfortunately with Jack not in the race, we came up a little short on them, but for being so close without having our fifth runner, one of our runners in the top five, it was good to see that we were still competitive with them.
We competed really good there. We almost beat they were fifth ranked in the nation. We lost them by like 3 points or something. So you're looking really good.
The boys would win 6 out of their 7 meets before going into the championship season. They would need to get top 3 as a team to qualify for the state meet. In their district meet, they managed to do something no other cross-country team has done before. They finished their top 5 runners 3rd through 7th with a split of just half a second apart. The first runner would finish with a time of 17:05.48, and the 5th runner would finish with a time of 17:05.99.
We were able to run, so the competition in the race wasn't like the greatest, but obviously you can't take anything for granted. So we just pack ran and we kept our whole team together, and at the very end we just made sure to finish as a team, even if that meant letting one or two people ahead of us. Running that 5-man line at the end and like showing the other teams and parents and every other competition there that we were a team and we could compete together and we were our entire pack just was kind of a statement there. Like, our time wasn't like the fastest there. It wasn't the most impressive, but that didn't matter because everyone knew we were capable of much faster.
It's like never been, it's never really happened. And we got a lot of recognition from other states and just people on social media, like amazed of that we did that as a team.
Districts was a really cool meet. You don't really see many teams that are able to qualify for state and also run together as a pack. Running together was kind of just symbolic in a way, just to show our connection through our team. And it's just really cool to see that a team works together this whole season, and they're able to have a great meet with each other, to push each other, and also just have fun. And that is one of my favorite meets right there, just because of our team. And we don't ever really get to see that.
I think it kind of showed how like strong we are as a team, that we could have five guys together and still qualify for state. And I also just think it shows like how our team is, and that we're able to run together and just work together.
Once again, the team qualified for state in Kearney. Millard West looked like the strongest runners in the state. It looked as if they would easily have it in the bag, but that wouldn't be the case. The Wildcats seemed to shut down during the race, and it all fell apart.
I think everything went wrong that they could.
I was definitely disappointed and like shocked that our team wasn't able to do it, considering we were nationally ranked and we were doing so well all season.
I was very disappointed in myself, because I just knew that as just someone that should have been up there in scoring, it just really hit hard, because I got one of the slowest runners in state that time, and it was not a good feeling. It was hard to overcome.
What seemed like such a winnable and favored race that we were almost for sure gonna win, like knowing our season that we had this year. I mean, like undefeated the entire season except for the one race, which was another team nationally ranked, and that was when we didn't have one of our better runners. So it seemed like there was no way we could have lost, but when I heard second, I guess we found that way, unfortunately.
When I heard that, my heart sunk, because I really thought we were gonna win, especially being nationally ranked. Lots of people expected us to get first, so it was a hard thing to take in, but I mean, you have to get through it. You just have to accept.
Getting second and losing to Fremont again wasn't the end for the Wildcats. They had one last chance to prove themselves this season. NXR, the regional cross-country meet. In a normal year, the first and second teams at NXR would compete at NXN, but because of COVID, it had to be canceled.
I think competing well at NXR was a must, because it was to show that even though we didn't do great at state, we still had fight in us left to do well.
Seeing some of the results populating here with the scores going through again, populating to a top five. So the Wildcat cross-country squad currently in the lead in the team standings with 130 points.
Wildcat XC remains up front, but not by much, only by one place, with the Stars in second with 154 behind the 153-point lead.
Once again, the Wildcats did something unexpected. Through the first and second mile, they were in first as a team. They slowly died off, but not by much. They finished in second place, the highest a Nebraska team has ever finished.
Competing well at NXR was almost a ticket into going to nationals. We had to at least get first or second at regionals, and it's also a very fun meet to go to, because you pull in all the great Midwest teams and we're all going at it. So it was just this cool atmosphere, but then it was also a ticket into going to nationals.
You heard that right. So, in replace of NXN, the team qualified for the Garmin Running Lanes Championship in replace of Nationals. 46 states in 6 countries were in Huntsville, Alabama to compete.
Pretty proud of our team and like how far we came, and I think it's crazy from like looking at freshman year to being at a national meet our senior year, and just how much we've changed, I guess.
Being at a national meet, the competition is going to be hard. There was one team that everyone had their eyes on.
Newberry Park for sure.
A school from California, Newberry Park, they were going for the records there, and they did really good.
Oh, definitely Newberry Park out of California.
The team out in California called Newberry Park.
Newberry Park, the best high school cross-country team in the nation, and they're standing on the same soil as Millard West, a team from Nebraska.
I mean, like before even the race, just like the days before, it was just like a great bonding experience that I'll like never forget with my teammates. It was all the games we did, all the pre-race prep that we did, and the car rides, it all just kind of made some great memories, and I'll never forget them. And the race itself, when we got to the line, we were seeing all the competition around us, and we were like, this is kind of like the best in the nation. Like, we made it. Like, we showed that we belong here, that we are up there as well with them. And then the race just felt like energetic. It felt like it was the one race that mattered the most the entire season.
Normally when you think of Alabama, you always think it's going to be warm, but it felt more like, it was definitely more of a chilly, but it wasn't unbearably cold. It was like a perfect racing conditions.
The Nationals environment was just very upbeat. There's a lot of people there that were going for new records, a lot of people there that were just out there to have fun and get, and then you also had another team there going for national records. So it was just cool to be there and race with them. And it was another race that was just not on our shoulders, that we had to, like, it was just one last fun meet with the team.
The team ran extremely well. 6 of the 7 runners ran a personal record. I caught up with the coaches and one of the runners after the race.
I mean, overall this year we started off really well and we ended with PRs, and that's really all you can ask, is run your best at the end of the season, which is what we did. Had a little disappointment at the state meet, but we came back and showed that we are by far the best team in the state, and kind of proved that today.
My season was a little rough. I had ups and downs throughout, but in the end it ended pretty well. The race was definitely very competitive and I felt pretty good. I mean, there were some moments where I got a little tired, but I felt good in the end and kicked. I think I'm gonna miss the team aspect of just everyone working together, and on the runs we're all just joking around with each other, and just a great team atmosphere that I'm gonna miss.
Runners represented themselves in the state of Nebraska in a way that is indescribable. Everyone ran PRs and I couldn't be happier.
With them running so well, they finished 25th in the nation, the best a team out of Nebraska has done.
Great season, Wes. Nice job.
Nice work.
Nebraska proud, guys.
I feel like it definitely represents how strong we can be and how we can build up a team just based off the people that we are given. And like, it's a very exciting experience for the Millard West team, and it's good to represent our school.
I just think it shows our strength in the program that we generate some of the best runners to come through Nebraska, and to have all of our best runners kind of land on one team shows that we did belong at that national meet. It wasn't a mistake. We were a national level team. We should have been there, and I'm glad that we got that experience and we had a chance to compete with them.
Well, it represents that, I mean, we were the first team to go there, and not many people knew that, but I think a lot of people do that after the fact, and it was just a good experience for Nebraska to get out there, because not many people think that we have any good programs here.
I think competing at Nationals represented our cross country team because it showed that we could push through struggle from later in the season and come out swinging.
I think it kind of just shows like what we've created, and like it just shows like you never expect a Nebraska team to go to a national meet. And I guess it just shows how like close our team is and how much we want it.
That was one of the most exciting and memorable moments of my life. Just the team and what we've gone through this whole season, and since freshman year, it's been my goal to make it to Nationals with the team or individually, and it was just awesome to be able to do that.
Excuse me, I've lost control of all of my senses. And you might have to excuse me, I've lost control of all of my world.